have a little bit of vocals in the monitor, maybe. Check one, two, hey, perfect. There we go.
And the other one, yeah.
Check one, two, three, four, wow, both ears now. Nice.
And I'll start the track again, then it's now for you.
Somebody to love.
Now we're down to the top. Anyway, but yeah, it's about to start the song.
Are you ready?
Yeah, sure.
Are you ready?
Sure.
Sit here and
eat my pork. Hi, everybody. I'm just sitting here minding my own business eating balls of pork. How are you?
Good.
Nice to see you. Welcome back to those of you who have returned. For those of you that are here for the first time, it's nice to meet you all. I hope you had a lovely day here at Copenhagen Guitar Show. Strongly suggest the pork balls. I don't know if they're actually balls. They're tasty nonetheless. By balls, I mean balls. I've eaten some weird stuff in the past month. I'm kind of on this kick of that whole, like, you know, live as if you're gonna die tomorrow. So I ate brains. I ate raw horse. What else have I done? Probably things I shouldn't say. But these are delicious. These are really good. Is it time to start, or should I just sit here and talk about pork balls for another 5 minutes? Think wave back, you don't got me shot. You want some pork? There you, getting the hug back there. You want some, does she want some pork?
Do I need it?
Anybody else want? You ate like half of it. My pork is your pork. At least I didn't say balls. All right. Now I'm nice and greasy. Let's get all the pork grease on the strings. It was nice and slippery. Skin shine. Makes a nice beard oil, too. All right. Should I just shut the hell up and start? What time? Is it time to start?
Yeah,
you're all here, so I guess I should start 4:04. We're 4 minutes late. I could have played a song instead of talking about my balls.
Alright, might as well start the way I always start, right? Tell me the apples. You know what?
Alright. You're gonna end up your guy, how much you hate your head, hit me like a flickering switch. You're my perfect angel, but sometimes all I see is a fucking bitch. The problems that you are, I know it's true, they're trying to fucking go back in my head. Everything has changed. Everything's so strange. Now you're stuck with that old thing. Oh, I love your friends, I'm a lady. Pushed all the time. For all the fun I have inside you, I believe, toss a good time. The problems may that much have seen, just something going on in my head. Everything has changed. Everything's so strange. Now you're stuck with having no more than ha! Now you're stuck with that normal life.
of both which I do too much.
Suck.
String. So instead of pressing the string against our metal fret, which is all we're doing, we're just shortening lengths of string and using our little assistant here that's providing us with those frets, those guides to do that in precise spots. I keep a metal cap on this finger that I press down notes with. So instead of pressing the string against the fret, this is like a mobile fret that I press against the string. And that's how I'm getting all those notes, because this is before they invented a whammy pedal. I should have waited 2 years. Back in like the 1980 something. So. Right here. What's this thing? So you just find the precise spots. And get everything like that. So that's how I'm getting all the high notes. Because it just got me thinking so much about the string. On how, you know, we limit ourselves to the fretboard and things we do on the fretboard, but it's really about the string. And we're doing things to the string. We're bending it. We're bringing out all these other overtones and different things to shape the sound. Vibrato, sliding in, this, that. The way we pick it or pluck it or whatever we do to it. So there's a lot more besides just the way we hit a note. There's a lot more notes we could be getting. And we'll talk more about that. Yes. What we're doing to get those notes is where, what I should say is the way to find those notes is you have to picture the octave of everything one step back. So you have to understand how the string is how it works. Okay, here to here is ringing from the nut to the bridge. It is vibrating 110 times. If you cut the string exactly in half, the halfway point, the way a guitar is set up, will be your 12th fret. And when the string length is shortened by one half, it doubles the speed that is vibrating. And we call that an octave. So, that's for any length of string, you cut it in half, and you'll get twice the speed, the frequency that is vibrating, and that is your octave. So, open string, 12 frets higher, that's half the length, twice as fast, that's your octave. Okay. Fifth fret. Half the length of that string, that vibrating section of string, would be 12 frets higher. Same thing. 17th fret. That's half the length, twice as fast, that's your octave. So, if half the length of a piece of string is where you find its octave, then you don't really need the frets anymore. All you have to do is just visualize halves of lengths of string. So, once you get to the top, and you're here, you're on the 17th fret, and you and you want to get your 29th fret, which you don't have. There's it, right there. So, now right there, you just look down, picture halfway, and hope for the best. And that's where you'll find the next octave. So now that is the quick, easy way to access the notes beyond the fretboard. And you don't necessarily need one of these on your finger to do that. You can simply just play things on the neck, touch down at the halfway point, and work. I'm not getting my flux today. What's going on? Sounds you want to get, because there's a whole lot of sounds on the string. What you realize about the string is that there's different layers to it. It's like, kind of like this is one plane of existence, the neck. Pressing down. Then, as you're dividing the string in half and getting harmonics, that's a whole other plane on top of it. You divide the string in half, hit the harmonic, doubles the frequency. At halfway point, 12 frets, blah, blah, blah. You go to one-third the length of string, that is where your seventh fret is. Or I should say, seven frets higher than any piece of vibrating string is where you will find the first one-third breaking point. So, seven frets up. It is one-third the length of string, it is three times the frequency. Whatever the fraction is that you're breaking it, that's the reciprocal of how it multiplies. So, one-third becomes 3/1 speed. 110, 1/3, 330. Then the other point that you would find the other 2/3 is from that 7th fret there, 12 frets higher. Why 12 frets? Because 2/3 are 1/2 of each other, and 1/2 is 12 frets. So it starts forming this little pattern, 7 frets, 12 frets. When you go toward 1/4 the length of string, that is 5 frets higher. And then the other 3/4 would be the same way. It would be 7 frets higher than that, or 12 frets higher than that. If you go to 1/5 the length of string, it'll be 5 times the frequency. And it'll be, that's around the 4th fret, and then you go 5 frets higher than that, or 7 higher than that, and you go 12 higher than that, where you don't have 12 frets higher than your 16th, that would be your 28th fret, and you don't have one, but you don't need one, because you know that all you have to do is cut the length of string in half. Like that. So, what happens is, over time, you just get better at seeing these fractional lengths of string, and you could just kind of find them. You just know exactly where that high is, because you do it so much. It's just like anything, you practice, and your eyes, your ears, and your hands all just fine-tune.
So yeah, so that's something to screw around with. Now, there's more to it than that. All right, so we have that first plane. I'm getting all hippie-ish and stuff. Our first plane of existence is the fretboard. Our second is your harmonics. Now, there's a third one, because here's the thing. You notice when you're breaking up these sections of string and making these divisions, you start to realize that whatever happens in one direction, it happens exactly the same in the other direction, sort of invisibly, I'll explain. The middle of the string is almost like this mirror that looks both ways. So when you're going like this, same exact thing, same distances, everything. And if that's going on, then that must mean that where the frets are, where the string shortens that way, should, in theory, go the same way, where if you're getting everything this direction, you're getting everything that direction. So if you're getting everything this direction, you should be able to get them that direction, which means that there's a little invisible fretboard right here that mimics this. So, let's say you want to shorten the string by this much, by one fret, you go. You should be able to do the exact same thing here and have the same thing happen. And it does. So if that's the case, then anywhere you play, because all we're doing is we're just using our fingers to shorten lengths of string, anything you're playing in this direction, you should be able to get the same length shortening in this direction. So, you go like this, and then you want to add another note. Shortening this piece to here, and then to here. We're just shortening it by that much, that much. So, let's take this piece right here. We're shortening the length by that much. So if we go right here, and shorten it from there, instead of getting... the notes that you want to get from either direction. Something to think about. Cool. Nice. Questions with that? This is just obvious nature stuff. We just don't bother to look. But now here's what's cool about it. There is one difference. This one, everything is in a fixed spot unless you got one of these. Using this, it is floating. So, all those notes that you're getting, they're not going to be, they don't have to be exact. You can get anything in between there. There is no, you're not bound to the frets. So, you can really start to make your guitar talk a little bit, just, you know. That you can start really getting a lot more sounds out. That's what I did. I had an old album called Hermit from 20 years ago on Shrapnel Records and Warner Records, and there was one song in there called I Can't Play the Blues, and I had this whacked out solo. At the end of it, I was doing this thing where I was using this and I was going up to like a high, and I just hold it there and I would let go. So you can really make the guitar start to talk in a way that you can't with just frets and playing in this one direction. So, that is your homework class, to start experimenting with that stuff. And just really thinking about the string. You are playing on the string, and a string is multi-dimensional. It's not just, you know, something you hit against a fretboard. It can do a lot more. So get all that out of there. Especially with, you know, harmonics and things like that, all the overtones you can get.
you can add so much more sound. Let's say you want to bend a note. You can put another note under it, like a harmonic, and then create an oscillation as they get closer to each other, and the waves are moving, right? And one is moving faster than the other, the higher note. And then as they get closer to each other, it slows down. The thing is, as these waves are combined into our ears, every once in a while, the sum of them cancels out, and you get this kind of sound. The whoa, 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 whoa. That's our sound canceling out when they come together and they're not happy. So when you can use that to create like other sounds, like listen to the speed that you can move around of the canceling out. You can hear as I bend these notes, this other thing that goes like like a humming. Okay? So there's a lot of things you could do with sound waves, combining them and using dissonance and tension to make the stuff speak more, which is why I love the fretless guitar, because with that, you can get all of that tension. Secondary voices. So, yeah, I like it. Very shiny. So, yeah, questions with that? Anything? Yeah.
What is it made of?
What is it made of? It's stainless steel. Okay. Yeah, and having something that's more dense and not porous, it does help with the system, definitely. That helps with sustain your fingernails, help with sustain. You're playing with your fingertips. But it does die. So, at that point, switch to your fingernail. Once in a while, you do that, play kind of like a oud or something. Yes. Good. Thank you. Well, what you can do is you can use both pickups, and then there are certain points you'll get a combination. Because the way the pickups pick up is that they pick up everything from here. So, if you want your bridge pickup, using this, you'll get all the higher notes because it's picking up the notes from here. So, kind of run out. If you want this one, you won't get those. A little bit. But really, what you can get is a shortening, as if you're moving the bridge this way. So, you can't get that on this bigger pickup. If you put the two together, you get a little mix. Be able to get them if you want them. Doesn't mean you have to use them just because you can. But have them. Good. So yes, this thing. I just want to do that song. Ha!
Swing Zeppelin.
Thank you.
As my treat, I play the song Nights I Get a Port Ball. I don't know why you let me do these things. I might have a question. I saw there was a lot of chicken picking stuff. I don't have a question about chicken picking. Oh, pork balls, yes.
Any good exercises for chicken picking?
Yeah, that song. So what I'm doing here, pork balls. So, taking the chords, E7, A7, D7, G. What goes up must come down. Fly me to the moon. 6-2-5-1. The 6 is the 5 of the 2, which is the 5 of the 5, which is the 5 of the 1. You look at the relationship between the chords. So, with that, you give them a dominant 7th, and it magnifies the resolve of the 5 to 1. Then you get all jazzy and you add a flat 5 on that. And then you arpeggiate to take each chord. In phase, out of phase. It's like kind of. So, and then you chicken pick. You gotta jump all around. So, chicken picking. Hold your pick. You got these fingers free and available. So you simply pluck. So nice exercises to start with that. My go-to first exercise would be take a C chord, take your pinky, put it on the high G right there, and you're going to pluck with your second finger. You're going to go up a C scale, an open position, up to D, and then back down.
Thank you.
take the jazz approach as well, and just hitting chords. And start just moving around, and you're hitting the chords with these fingers and hitting your moving the bass lines, you're picking them. You start taking them. And use your fingers. Put them together. Taking songs and adding parts together, use all your fingers. Start experimenting with multiple lines at once, where you're picking one line and you're plucking the other. Definitely. Good. Cool. Good stuff. Yes. More questions? No.
Yes, I have one more.
Yeah.
Not to talk about the time.
You have to stop me early because I go and then I don't stop.
Like 10 minutes. But anyway, about the guitar, I know all your great guitars. You have many guitars, I suppose, but you most play on this, and when you do your gigs all around the world, also this.
Yeah.
Okay.
This is pretty much the main one. This is my everything go-to, all-in-one, multi-purpose guitar.
Yeah.
It's my signature model and design. For that reason, to be that way.
Do you make any shows acoustics?
I did a whole bunch. I did my first acoustic shows, where it was just me alone on a stage with an acoustic guitar, singing and playing. I just did those in Japan a month ago, and did one actually a few nights ago in Poland, in fact, yes. It's fun, I like that.
So,
you're
going to Denmark?
Wow, 4 years. This won't be back for 4 years. I can come back next month.
Yeah, okay.
I can be back next week,
next
but it's
year.
Like
next year,
4 years.
Yeah. It's because we
need enough time to. Yeah, I was here in 2013, back now. So, yeah, I'll see you in 2021, God willing.
Yeah.
You know, when you reach my age, you start saying God willing with everything, you know? It's not like see you in 4 years, it's like see you in 4 years, I hope. So, I play court acoustic guitars. They have a new series coming out in a couple of months, a gold series, it's real nice. This one is from a French company called Vigier, V-I-G-I-E-R. I've been with them about 20 years. They make nice stuff. They use the graphite sheet going through the neck instead of a truss rod. The neck stayed pretty good. We got the fretless thing going. So this is my everything guitar. I got a Floyd here that I don't use. I got Tone Zone DiMarzio's, Chopper DiMarzio's, 5-way, bridge single coil, humbucker, single coil, two pickups together, two out of phase, and then just the humbucker. I mean, just the neck thing, yeah. Same on both guitars. This is where you switch necks. Here's one neck. Here's both. And here's just this one. Although you do get some kind of overtones and stuff, so you could do things like. Chambered in, so this one is light as a feather. My God, look at that. That's not even a high level, baby. So, yeah. Oh, I can play another song. I'm going to do that.
Yes. Yeah. And then the last one. I'm sorry, no. Then the last one.
Ah.
Would you like to do the one from last, from yesterday? I don't know who to play for anymore.
I could, but that one's kind of wrong.
Yeah, but then you have maybe 6 minutes.
Okay.
You say it's so beautiful.
I just have to finish chewing my popcorn. I should have eaten the whole thing at once.
I'm not afraid to.
2 and 4 years. It's been a pleasure. Thanks so much. Thank you for having me.
Hope to see you back.
Definitely, anytime. I got one last pork ball. Who wants it? You want it? You can have it if you want. Or your phone.